Thanks for sticking for the last talk. We'll get started. So Concourse is actually a near real-time notifications platform that we have recently built at LinkedIn. So roughly the outline of the talk is as follows. First, we'll give you a little bit of background on how notifications experience is set up at LinkedIn, and spend a little bit of time looking into how near real-time notifications are used in LinkedIn. And this is the class of notifications which Concourse powers today. After this, we can go into a little bit of nuts and bolts of how Concourse enable these kind of notifications, and spend a little bit of time on how we made some performance improvements in order to scale to the first application that we launched. Finally, we'll just show you a couple of results about using this Concourse on some real use cases at LinkedIn. So to give you an overview of notifications at LinkedIn, the goal here is to actually communicate timely and relevant information to our member. So here, we want to bring users back to LinkedIn so that they can engage with the platform, and they don't necessarily miss anything that's happening in the platform. Our missions for notifications is actually to deliver the right content to the right people at the right time using the right channel for all our members. I've just given you a couple of examples of notifications. So for example, when somebody in your network is mentioned in the news, we might send you a notification about that activity. Another example of a notification use case is in the case of transactional type of events, which are things like connection invites and whatnot. The way we actually notify the user that there is a notification waiting for you is actually in one of two ways. In addition to adding the notifications inside the LinkedIn app, we notify the user using either a UI push, which is basically a notification on your phone's notification tab. This is used for more timely and notifications which really require your immediate attention. Slightly less urgent notifications are just include a badge update. So your app icon actually flashes with a slight badge and potentially a count of number of notifications waiting for you. So how is the notifications experience set up at LinkedIn? So here is roughly the set of components that power notifications today. On the left-hand side, you see the content generators. So there are different types of content generators, like, for example, for transactional M2M notifications, there's a system that generates these. Concourse is one of the main components here for near real-time content generation. There are other platforms for offline content generation and certain other things for legacy use cases. All of these content generators generate notifications for you, and that is actually processed by a centralized system called a traffic controller. It's kind of a gateway to regulate member experience so that we provide a unified and joint methodology to ensure that member experience is regulated. Coincidentally, ATC is also a SAMHSA system, but it has been running at LinkedIn for quite some time. Once the notifications go through ATC, they are available in the notification service, which is used to serve these notifications. On the other hand, Flock is one of the services which we use to either do a UI push or a badge update to notify the user that there is a notification waiting for them. In some cases, we might choose to send you an email instead of notification just because the information is not that time critical. So with that broad overview, I'll go a little bit into nearline non-transactional notifications, which are what is powered by Concourse today. So the goal here for nearline non-transactional notifications is to proactively reach the right audience with highly relevant content in a timely fashion. So these kind of content will help them engage with their community, with their network, and consume content so that they can boost their professional goals. So a couple of examples here, which I'll allude back again and again, is one is activity-based notifications, things like job change or daily news or breaking news, which we might want to send out to our users. There are obvious benefits and challenges in this notification systems. One set of benefits is that it allows us to reach out to our members to keep them informed. We can surface LinkedIn's value. In certain types of notifications, like activity-based notifications, we can ensure that people who engage with the platform have an audience that they can reach through their engagement. And in general, these notifications help us move members through the engagement funnel. Of course, these type of notifications come with challenges, and this is why we need systems like Concourse to be available to solve those challenges. The first thing is the case of irrelevant notifications. Like if we want to make sure that we have the best quality notifications that we sent out. So that means that we need to have relevance. Of course, as when we send out more notifications, like we might also lead to disablement, like people might disable the notification channel, or they might just disable the notification app, or they might even uninstall the app. And if we have a very poor member experience, it also leads to a bad reputation for LinkedIn. With that in mind, I'll go through the main use case with which we started developing Concourse at LinkedIn. This is activity-based notification. So here, when a member posts or shares an item in the LinkedIn feed, we want to notify their close network colleagues or members, like who have historically interacted well with them, about the fact that their connection is posted and engaged with timely information in the feed. So this is not an experience which didn't exist before Concourse came in. It was actually powered by an offline system which was running frequently. There were challenges in running, like serving notifications through the system. First is the time delay. There was a large time delay, which meant that members can only be notified quite a bit after the activity has happened. And also because of the fact that we wanted to minimize time delay, we couldn't do extensive targeting, which meant that we had to severely curtail the experience to our member just for the sake of having a legacy offline flow. So these two things are something that Concourse solves for us. And in general, nearline processing is the answer to these kind of notifications, because a lot of our members expect a snappy member experience. So as soon as members post on LinkedIn, they want to see the engagement in real time, not in near real time, not something that's delayed by 4 hours. So with that, I'm actually going to hand over to Vivek, who will go a little bit into Concourse and how it solves the problem which we described.
Thanks, Ajith. So we will dive deeper into how Concourse was built and how it leverages some of the core functionality that SAMSA provides to operate at the scale it does. All right, so this is a high-level requirement of what Concourse needs to do. Concourse needs to consume the notification trigger or the activity notification that will cause notifications to be sent out. Concourse would then need to identify potential candidate recipients for this, basically fan out these notifications to the posters, networks like connections and followers. And for each recipient that Concourse identify, we need to assign a score, we need to then prune all the low-quality notifications which are most likely not going to be of value to our members. And then we fire off an event to Air Traffic Control or ATC. ATC further refines the fan out that Concourse has identified and applies some rule-based filtering, such as whether it's in the right time zone for the member, etc., and finally delivers a smaller subset of notifications to our members. All right, so this is the high-level overview of how Concourse is built. So Concourse is built as a series of SAMSA jobs or tasks, each with a particular feature and its own scaling characteristics. So the idea, the first task is the repartitioner, which acts as a main interface to get events into Concourse. And the idea is also to make repartitioner the single touch point for different use cases which want to onboard their own triggers or events to Concourse. The pre-fanout job will decorate some features that can be for the notification that can be decorated before fanout. Fanout is a component that talks to various graph services available at LinkedIn to identify potential recipients. And finally, scoring scores the notification for each recipient, identifies a score, applies relevance-based filtering, and finally sends out an event to ATC. So we'll look into each of these stages in detail. So first one is the workflow manager or repartitioner. So as I mentioned before, repartitioner is expected to serve as the primary interface for new applications who want to new use cases that want to leverage Concourse to deliver their notification. So for each new use case that who want to deliver notification, the idea is the SAMHSA task consumes one single input stream. For example, for activity notifications or notifications about members posting stuff, the workflow manager listens to an input stream. For another use case such as job change, the workflow manager listens to another input stream. The workflow manager also decides for a given use case what's the type of fan out that needs to be done. For example, one use case might want to fan out to a member's network. Another use case might want to fan out to all members who have participated in a comment thread, and so on. The workflow manager decides this. The workflow manager then also standardizes the schema so that the rest of the stages can be schema agnostic to our use case schemas and process this message. And the workflow manager also repartitions this message based on the ID or the URN of the message sender. This is because the next stage, which is the feature decorator, has local SAMHSA key value stores for actor features, and we do a streaming join on the feature decorator based on the ID. So in order for the streaming join to work, the partitioning for the database and the partitioning for the input Kafka stream have to match. So I'm going to skip the feature decorator stage because it's fairly simple in what it does. The next important stage is the fanout. So fanout consumes the input message and fans out along a graph. So what is a graph? A graph can be anything, any system that associates one member with another member based on certain types. For example, we have the connection graph at LinkedIn, which tells you who is connected to which members. We have the follow graph, which tells you which members are following another member to receive their content, for example. We can have other kinds of graphs. Like I mentioned, we have the comment graph, which basically gives you, given a comment, what are all the people who have participated in the discussion along the comment. The fanout can also be thought of as a different way. The fanout can be done based on the characteristic of a member. And for example, such an example might be to fan out a piece of breaking news to all LinkedIn members who reside in the Bay Area and who work in the tech sector. So that could be another example of fan out. So the first use case, which is fan out based on graph, is the more simple and the more common use case. In this one, the fan out receives a message from the previous state. It makes a REST call to a graph API externally, paginates through a request, and for each recipient that the fanout stage identifies, it sends off a message to the scorer. The second stage of fanout is where it iterates through the set of attributes that we store for each recipient, and based on whether the recipient attributes match with the message's intended target, if there's a match, it identifies and sends out another message. So the second kind of targeting is done in parallel, where we have multiple fanout tasks, and each fanout task receives the same message, and it attributes over its local data set. And the local data set is attributes for the entire LinkedIn network distributed across multiple fanout machines. So this way, we are massively parallelizing the fanout and target matching. So the next stage is the scorer. So in the previous stage, the fanout not only identifies the recipient, but it also repartitions the input stream and now partitions it based on the recipient. This is because the scorer, again, needs to do a streaming join for recipient and edge features. And this can only be done at the scorer because the recipient and the edge are identified at fanout. And since we can potentially send out thousands of messages for each trigger based on the kind of fanout we are doing, the scorer is also scaled much more massively than the rest of the components. and as a consequence cannot afford to make network calls in order to fetch information that it needs for scoring. So all this information needs to be made available locally in SAMHSA's key value store. The scorer also uses side inputs, which is a new feature that was pretty much built for Concourse by the SAMHSA infrastructure team at LinkedIn in order to make this feature ingestion as efficient as possible. All right, so this is the feature process. So in order for Scorer to ingest these features, we need to make these features available in a Kafka stream. Now, let's talk about what are features. So features are properties of members, content, edges, et cetera, that are taken into account while generating a relevant score for a particular notification. So we have different teams at LinkedIn that produce these features. An example for a feature might be the strength of a connection edge between two members. It could also be the propensity of a recipient to react to different content. For example, I as a recipient might like articles more, but someone else might be more inclined to consume video-based content. So these are all features that are learned offline about members, and they are available in different sources. Different teams maintain their own feature maps, and some of these are available as HDFS data dumps, and they are updated in batches. Some others are more continuous. For example, we have a feature about when is the last time a member visited a site, and that is continuously being updated and is available as a Kafka stream. So the task of the feature processor is to consume features from these multiple sources, standardize them, repartition them again based on the recipient so that the scorer can then do a streaming join for all this feature data. All right, so Concourse also supports relevance as a first-class citizen so that the notifications that are generated to Concourse are the most relevant to our members. So in order to do that, Concourse needs to access different kinds of features. So we access different features in different stages. Features like features of the sender who generated the notification and features of the content for which we are being notified are available pre-fan-out and can be either accessed via REST calls to different sources or as local SAMHSA KV store lookups. Concourse also supports members and edge features, and these are solely accessible post fan out and have to be made via local SAMHSA lookups. And in order for us to constantly improve our relevance models, we also need to take a snapshot of data and join it with what the member actually did with his notification so that the models are constantly learning and updating themselves based on changing member preferences. So Concourse also supports this out of the box by allowing us to snapshot certain data that is used for scoring and being made available for model training. And the most important part, Concourse supports scoring and filtering, and it also supports scoring based on single utility or multiple utilities. In what I mean by utility is a single dimension for which a message can be relevant to a member. A dimension can be the propensity of a message to click the content and consume it. Another dimension could be the propensity of a member to send a message to the content creator or perhaps participate in a comment thread and discussion about the content. So we have support in Concourse to either optimize for a single utility or score for multiple utilities and then generate an aggregate score so that to deliver the most relevant content to our members. And Concourse is also designed as a platform. So we have multiple use cases that get onboarded to Concourse. And ideally, the repartitioner or the workflow manager phase should be the single touch point for onboarding new content, mostly because Concourse already supports a wide variety of fan-out graphs and a wide variety of feature fetchers. So the onboarding process can be as simple as adding a new Kafka stream and providing a mapper class to map the input data source into Concourse's data schemas. However, if required, we also provide hooks to onboard different item features or different source features. And we also provide hooks to talk to different new kinds of fan-out graphs or ingest new member attributes to target members along different dimensions. All right, so performance optimization. As Samarth mentioned at the beginning of the talk, Concourse pretty much stressed out the SAMHSA and infrastructure at LinkedIn. Let's find out how we did that. All right, so this is the scale at which Concourse operates. At a peak, we score about 500,000 notifications per second. And out of those, we rank notifications and filter them out pretty aggressively, sending out only 2000 message notifications to ATC, and ATC further does pruning of these messages. And the recipient and the edge feature data that we store come up to about 34 billion records and serialized occupy about 2 terabytes of space on disk. We also massively parallelized this task and created 1024 tasks to achieve some of the scale. And the SLA that Concourse provides is 60 seconds end-to-end delay between when Concourse received a message and when Concourse identified the fanout, scored, filtered, and sent a message to ATC. So here are some of the optimizations that helped Concourse to scale at this. So while we are building Concourse, the biggest challenge was the feature ingestion. So as I mentioned before, it is 34 billion records and 2 terabytes of data that is pretty much updated on a weekly basis. And so this part, keeping up with this part causes a lot of stress. So what we discovered early on was the way in which feature data was represented could be highly optimized. So we were using repeated strings and other non-optimal data structures. So we had this major project to basically use strongly typed schemas, which got us a 4x byte size reduction for the same message volume. And some of this feature data is also generated offline and are updated in batches. So we built some intelligence into the Hadoop infrastructure that generates, that takes this offline data and creates a Kafka stream out of it to identify what are the records that were changed since the last push, and basically push a delta with a full push being done once or twice a week. This helps us have a reasonable snapshot of the snapshot event without stressing the underlying systems too much. And in order to further provide safeguards, the features processor, which basically acts as a gatekeeper for input feature data into Concourse, does traffic shaping and rate limits how much we ingest. So the scorer has two tasks. One is to score notifications and one is to ingest feature data. One is more important than the other. We want to score messages as quickly as we can because we can tolerate a slight delay or age of features. So the features processor rate limits traffic that goes into scoring, enabling it to prioritize its input streams properly. And we also work closely with our SAMHSA infra partners to as we were building and scaling this platform. And there were a few features that we used, existing features, and a few features that were built for Concourse scale. The biggest one for us was host affinity. Since we have a significant amount of state that we store, we don't want our tasks to move to different physical hosts each time we deploy, because that would involve bootstrapping from changelog, and that takes hours. So we extensively make use of host affinity so that the task comes back on the same machine and need not refresh its key value stores. The Concourse workload was also high enough that SAMHSA team built out a dedicated cluster for us so that we basically own the machines on which we run, and any load that we generate does not affect some of the other hundreds of jobs that run on the shared SAMHSA cluster at LinkedIn. And the system also makes heavy use of SAMHSA local state in order to make scoring at state possible. We wouldn't have been able to perform network lookups for features that we need post fanout to score. And we also distribute traffic across data centers so that notifications are generated for members parallelly across all of LinkedIn's data centers. The other feature that SAMHSA team specifically built for us is side inputs, wherein we input feature data into our local key value stores in an efficient way. The current implementation causes double writes. The features processor or the source of the feature generates this data. We write it into SAMHSA's key value store, and SAMHSA's key value store then writes it into changelog, and this is very inefficient. So the side inputs basically optimizes the way in which this ingestion is done without having this massive data replication. And Ajith will talk about the results of this project.
So we are using Concourse today for at least powering two of our notification experiences. The first use case that we onboarded was activity-based notifications, which we were both describing during the talk. In that case, we immediately saw increased user engagement, which is not surprising given that we reduced the delay from 4 hours to just a few seconds. Qualitatively also, our members responded with good remarks about the product. In addition, we also have migrated our job change notification system from offline to online. And even in this case, we saw that in addition to increased engagement on the recipient side, the person who updated their job profile also saw increased response rates, and there was increased engagement overall in the system. With these two use cases being successful, we are already onboarding many new use cases for Concourse. We look at Concourse as basically the platform that serves any near real-time notifications experience at LinkedIn. With that, I would like to end the talk and thank you all for staying and listening to our presentation. And we'd also like to thank our partners and different individuals at LinkedIn who made this platform happen. Any questions?
When did you enable?
So it is like we have slowly started experimenting this experience as early as end of last year, but we have completely moved to this recently in the previous or the first quarter of this year.
So you can ask questions.